Hello world, Mr. Resistor here, continuing our alpha journey. And this is part two from yesterday. If you've seen it, you already know. But quick recap, we're testing out the Defend Contested Faction Warfare Complex daily. We tried doing one in a rear guard system. It did not count. We tried doing one in a frontline friendly system, and unfortunately got ganked right before we capped it, so inconclusive. And also we failed to get useful intel. Let's go ahead and take a look at our kill report. Let's see, how does I don't remember how. It's not what I want. It's not what I want. That's not what I want. How do I share this again? There we go. All right. Crucifier. I know it's Amar, I can never remember. Just basic. Frigate. Kate. I think that's Kaldari. No. Ah, Galente T3 Destroyer. All right. Hmm. Ouch. Well, whatever. It's fine. Didn't include. Weird. Okay. All right. We are back in business. Try that actually. Nah, I think Turner's gonna be a better. All right.
Warp drive active.
Yeah, we'll go Red Force this time.
Warp drive active.
Warp
drive active.
All right, so we know a rear guard system complex won't satisfy this, so gonna try command operations. Front line. Hopefully, the Amar and the area are all busy getting the battlefield. And we might jump in to this Israbada battlefield as well. Doesn't seem like Minmatar forces are interested in the one in Asset, which is not a surprise. As I recall, friendly battlefields are worth a whole lot less.
Warp drive active.
Command operations. Here
warp
we
drive
go.
Active. Drive active.
Transverse bulkheads. Interesting. Hull head points. Huh. Makes sense as a trade-off. Uh-huh. All right, well, that completed it. So let's take a look here. Right. So, to swap out the afterburner.
Warp drive active.
Swap out the afterburner for meta. And then maybe I can swap this. Give me a little bit more tank.
Warp drive active.
So let's see. We're going. Right. Okay. So for sitting at 7,500 meters, pretty close to optimal. Nice. First aerator gives us a rate of fire, gyro stabilizer, it's also rate of fire and damage. As long as we're able to kite them, we should be good as far as tracking. If they're much faster than us, of course, could be a problem. All right. But anyway, got one question answered. Which is, I think, that, let's see, that's what we're looking for. All right, only 2,800 loyalty points for that. Fine, whatever. But essentially, in order to satisfy the daily, we're capping a Action Warfare Plex, it needs to be one that's going to award loyalty points. Alright, I'll mark all those as red. All good.
Warp drive active. Warp drive active.
Let's see. A lot of people in the system. What's going on? Big fleet of some sort coming in? Let's check his Rabada.
Warp drive active. Warp drive active.
What's going on in asset?
Warp drive active. Warp drive active. Warp drive active. Warp drive active. Warp drive active.
It's just out of range. Do I dare go to the sun? Battlefield's over there.
Warp drive active. Warp drive active.
All right, I will also jump in. Get some of that sweet, sweet Battlefield LP.
Warp drive active.
Figure out how that site works. All right. Where is... All right, so since somebody asked, or somebody mentioned that they didn't really understand what was going on one of my... previous videos where we're capturing a battlefield, right? So let's take a quick overview here. We've got our three capture points, right? So that's A, that's B, and that's C. Capturing any of these, right? When you've got the Minmatar symbol here, right? As long as this circle is advancing, we're getting points, which is advancing the victory counter here. All you need is one friendly ship within a 30 kilometer sphere. You can see the dots lining the thing here. There will be friendly and unfriendly NPCs. They spawn at the capture points. Whenever you wipe out all of one side, a new group will spawn in. So the normal strategy is kill all but one red battlecruiser. And then you just have to keep it outside of the 30 kilometer sphere, and you'll be capturing that point. So, and so basically we're already at that point on all of these capture points. By the way, typically a single cruiser is enough to maintain this. These guys are holding it down with frigates, right? While this group of cruises. Now the other thing, three points that you need to be aware of are the warp endpoints. So here's the Minmatar friendly one. Down here we've got neutral, and over here, is that the battlefield as a whole, or is that Minmatar? No. Yes, this is the battlefield as a whole. Minmatar warp endpoint is here. Since I'm just in a frigate and can't really do a whole lot that's useful, gonna go hang out at the MR warp in, so if any of them do come in, I can hopefully lock them down and survive long enough to help get a kill. All right, so anyway, this one is in an Amar controlled system, as you can see here. That makes it an offensive battlefield for Minmatar. And those are going to be your best source of LP as far as stuff that I've done. I mean, if you're doing higher level plexes, they can pay out pretty well. Also, I think I tend to stick to small or scout, just because those are the ships that I'm willing to risk. Although a decent fit Thrasher can run a medium. And those pay out pretty well. Payouts have been adjusted since I was last doing a lot of faction warfare. So bear that in mind, I guess. I'm not going to give exact numbers. We'll see what this pays out. Typically, though, your best payout is gonna be in an enemy-controlled frontline system. Obviously, those are also gonna be the ones with the highest risk of PvP, and I suspect that's the point. Let's see. Anything else you need to know? like all of the plexes, you need to be in it at the moment that it finishes in order to get credit. You also need to be in a ship that's actually capable of doing something. So that means minimum a frigate. I can say for sure you won't get credit. If you're in a pod, I don't think you will. If you're in a what are they called? The free ship. So let's see, we got a Rifter and a Tristan. Vexer is mostly a drone boat, so, and could easily apply damage at that range. Not sure about these guys. See, Hurricane. All right, medium turrets, so I mean, definitely not 200 kilometers range. Prophecy, medium energy turrets. I think energy turrets are relatively low range. I mean, depends on the fit, obviously. But I don't think 100k. I'd be real surprised if he had that kind of range. Awesome. 150k. Very good. All right. We're gonna do
warp drive. Send back active. Home.
drive active. Warp drive active.
Alright, waiting on a response before I head out any further. Alright, if they're gonna try and take that battlefield, I'd want in on that.
Drive active. Warp drive active. Warp drive active.
All right, well, it looks like it's probably not happening, so.
Warp drive active. Drive active. Drive active.
All right. Well, while we're traveling, what did I spend? Oh no, I didn't get the points yet. There we go.
Drive active.
Oh man, that guy had a bad day.
Drive active. Drive active. Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
That's going to be it for me for today. So until next time, have a good one.